a group of enthusiasts in Rochdale realised that it was the last pug. There were 50, I think, built, and there was just the one left. And they managed to get the money together. I think it cost £350, but you could have bought a Mini for that in those days. That was in 1963. I think it was November 63 when it was withdrawn. And they bought it early in 1964. And it was the first engine to go to the Keighley and Worth Valley Railway. So it, you know, it has a very sort of favoured place in the history of the line. Not wishing to blow my own trumpet, but I sort of foresaw that its centenary was coming up, and that the thing had been stood in the Worth Valley's museum for 25 years almost, and well, over 20 years, and that if we didn't get our skates on, you know, we'd miss the centenary. So we decided on a plan of action to get it restored, and unusually, rather than sort of working up to a last-minute schedule, which they always do on television programmes. In fact, we got it running 3 years before its centenary. So that was in 1997, when it started running again. And in that time, it's been to about a dozen different places. It's been to Bristol, which is only a preserve port nowadays. Everything, all the work in port is down at Avonmouth, and in the city of Bristol it's just a museum. Thank you. When they were built for the Lancashire and Yorkshire Railway, the L&YR was one of the biggest harbour owners. They had the harbours at Goole, at Fleetwood, Liverpool, places like that, where they worked at. But they also worked at Salford low-level goods, which had the very sharp curves like this. But they did have 50 of them, and I do wonder where on earth they found, work for quite so many.
So in Liverpool, they'd be on sort of transfer goods between dock warehouses and the Mersey Docks and Harbour Board.
That's right, lines. Yes. And some of them had spark arresters because they worked underneath the Liverpool Overhead Railway. Yeah.
And those were shedded at Bangor, I believe.
Yeah, there were some at Bangor, and I think there were some at Aintree as well. But they did have, I think they had about 15 of them.
But they seem to have got around quite a way, Derby, Bristol, Goole, Liverpool.
They did. When the L&YR became part of the LMS, they started to go wider afield. And in fact, 51218 ended up on the western region down at Swansea or somewhere down that way, Neath, I think it was. But by the time it had got there, with only having little wheels, they used to run hot. It set off from Horwich in Lancashire. By the time it had got down to Neath, the job that it had gone for had disappeared, and all they could use it for was taking the wage packets to all the outlying shunters' cabins. And
what do they like to drive?
Well, on ordinary track, they're very easy because all the controls are lightweight. But when you get on these dock lines, it's very hard. You're bouncing up and down all the time, and you can feel the the hardness coming through.
The other vehicle.